Good morning everyone, I am Karan Singh and today in this video we will see a topic of English grammar, that is past continuous tense. This is the seventh part of this video. So let's come to start. So first of all we will see what is past continuous tense. So what is past continuous tense? Past continuous tense is used to denote an action that was going on at some time in the past. What is past continuous tense? It is used to denote an action. It is used to denote an action that was going on at some time in the past. So there we will use past continuous tense to write or to translate the action which was continue, which was going on when in the past, any time in the past, there we will use past continuous tense. Alright, so let's move to towards some examples. It will be cleared here. Number one, he was going to market. Here this action was continue, was being continued by someone. So that is why here past continuous tense has been used. See the next example, Rani was going to market. This action was also continue in past. That is why here past continuous tense has been used. Number three, it was raining. So this work was continue in past. That is why here also past continuous tense has been used. I hope the concept of past continuous, when past continuous is used, is clear to you all. Let's move to the next thing, that is the rules. So let us see some rules of a past continuous tense which are used in writing the action or writing or speaking the thing, the work which was continue at some time in past tense. So there are some rules. Number one is a helping verb. Which type of helping verb we use in past continuous tense? So was and were are used as a helping verb in past continuous tense. Which one? Was and were. These two are used in past continuous tense as a helping verb. See, was, it is used with singular subject. So you know what is singular subject because this has been taught in your previous class. The single thing, one thing, a single thing alone, a subject which is single, alone, one, that is known as a singular subject. And the second is with I also, was is used. See some examples, as he was, she was, it was, Ram was, Shyam was, etc. Not two names, single name of a person, single name of a place, single name of a things, that will be singular. And with a singular noun we always use was where in past continuous tense. Let us move to the next thing, that is were. It is used with a plural subject. So what is plural subject? More than one. So more than one, that is called plural subject. Whether that is a name of a subject, name of a place, name of the things, they are plural subject, and we use were with plural subject as a helping verb where in this tense, past continuous tense. As for example, you were, they were, we were, Ram and Sam, because there are two names, etc. So this helping verb is used with the plural subject. I hope the use of were, was and were now cleared you all. Let's move to the next rule, that is main verb. So main verb, Fourth form of the verb is used in past continuous. So here in past continuous tense, we will use fourth form of the verb. What is fourth form of the verb? It is taught in the very beginning. When I started teaching tense, then I taught you all how to form fourth form and fifth form, because first form, second form and third form we have to learn, but fourth form and fifth form we can make. So there I taught you how to form, what are the rules for forming fourth form and fifth form. So if it is not clear how to form fourth form and fifth form, so you can go and watch the previous videos, it will be cleared there. So but first of all, but after all, I will give one glimpse how to form it here, but not in detail. So if you want to know in detail, you can visit, you can see, you can watch the previous video. So what is fourth form? When ing, you know, when this ing is added where? In first form. Then which form is formed? No, that is known as a fourth form. When ing is used in first form, then fourth form is formed. So what's form is formed? That is known as a fourth form. So see the example. Here number one. Dance is a first form, and here ing is added, that is why which form is here formed, that is known as a fourth form of the verb dancing. So ing form of the verb, ing form of any verb, that is known as a fourth form of the verb. See the second example, sing plus ing, singing. So here singing is the fourth form of the verb. See the next example, run plus ing, running. So running is here fourth form of the verb. Okay, let's see one more thing here. A verb ending e, and we have to make, if we have to make fourth form of the verb, then e is removed. See, dance, dance, ing, dancing. So e is removed when we form fourth form of the verb. If any verb ending e and we have to form the verb into fourth form, then e is removed in forming fourth form. Sing plus ing and run. So if a verb ending a consonant and just before the consonant there is a vowel and we have to just form that form, that verb in fourth form, then we have to write two times the consonant and then ing. Then we add ing for making fourth form of the verb. See the example, run, ru, and last is a consonant and that's just before and there is a u and that is vowel. So in forming fourth form means ing form, we have to write r u double n i n g. So by this way we form fourth form of the verb. I hope this brief introduction how to form fourth form in different way in different situation has been clear to you all. So let us move to the next thing, that is structure. So structures are very important in making or in forming the sentences. It tells us the appropriate place of words in the particular sentence. So the first structure is structure for affirmative sentences. When there is affirmative sentence, then we use this structure. First we use subject, after subject we use helping verb, then main verb, then other word. For example, see number one, they were playing football. So here they is a subject, were is a helping verb, playing is a main verb, I mean fourth form, football here an object, yeah you can say other word. See another example. I was doing my work. So I is a subject, was is a helping verb, doing is a main verb, and my work is other word. See the next example. Ramesh was writing a letter. So Ramesh as a subject, was as a helping verb, writing as a main verb, and a letter is a other word, etc. So these are the structure. Now these are a formative sentence, and this has been written on the basis of this structure. I hope this is clear to you all. Let us move to the next structure, that is negative. The structure for negative sentence, we have to also write and speak negative sentence. So what structure we will apply for speaking negative sentence? So first of all, we use subject, then helping verb, and just after helping verb we have to mention not, and after not we have to write fourth form of the verb, and lastly other word. You can say object plus other word. See the example. Number one, Suman's sister, this is a subject, was not helping verb, and not cooking, this is the fourth form, and there is no other word, that is why it has not been mentioned. So Suman's sister was not cooking, this is a sentence of a negative. Next is they were not cooking, they were not smoking, they as a subject, were not smoking. And see the third sentence, he was not giving the speech, he was not giving the speech. So these are the negative sentence, and here this structure, you know, negative structure has been applied to form. So very important to learn the structure of negative sentence. So let's see the next structure, that is yes no question. First of all, let's understand what is yes no type. So a sentence which is started with the helping verb in English, and in Hindi a sentence which is started with a word, a question word, that is kya, that is kya. So that is and can be answered, and can be answered by yes or no, means that question, that sentence, that question can be given, that question, that questions means answers can be given of that questions by in yes or no. So that will be known as a yes no type questions. So what will be the structure of yes no type questions? Let's see here. First of all, we use helping verb, and just after helping verb will be subject. If there is a negative sense in the sentence, then we can use not after subject, and then before and other word, and finally this mark, question marks. One more structure you can also apply, helping verb with not, and then subject, then before and other word. So this can be also applied, and this one can be also applied. Both the structure will be correct. Let's see the example. Number one, was your teacher teaching in the class? So here sentence has been started with the helping verb, and it can be answered by yes or no. If someone is asking you was your teacher teaching in your class? Yes sir, he was teaching in my class. No sir, he was not teaching in my class. So this question can be answered by yes or no, that is why this is known as a yes no type question. See the next example. Were you helping the poor? Yes, I was helping the poor. No, I was not helping the poor. This can be also answered by yes or no, that is why this is yes no type question. Third is, was Sam writing a poem? If someone is asking you, was Sam writing a poem? Yes, Sam was writing a poem. No, Sam was not writing a poem. So A sentence which is started with the helping verb and can be answered by yes or no, that will be known as a yes no type questions. And here in past continuous tense, yes no type question contains this structure. Okay, let's move to the next structure, that is a WH question. What is a WH question? When a sentence which is started with a question word and the answer of this question cannot be given by yes or no, then that will be known as a WH question. Means a sentence, or you can say an interrogative sentence which cannot be answered by yes or no, that will be known as a WH question. And what structure we apply here? First of all, we use question word, then helping verb, then subject, then not, then before, then other word, then question mark. So this is the structure to form this question. Let's see the example number one. Where were Ram and Mohan? Ram and Mohan going this morning. Where, this is the question word. Were is a helping verb. Ram and Mohan as a subject, going is a fourth form, and this in other word. So this is an interrogative sentence, and in interrogative this is WH question. See the next example. Why was your father not helping in your studies? So why, this is also it, because it cannot be answered by yes or no, this is WH question. See the next example. How were they doing the work? So this cannot be also answered by yes or no. That is why this is WH questions. See the next thing. Now we will see the use of past continuous tense in various situations. In different situations where we use past continuous tense. This is very important. So here number one, it is used to show the action which was continued at the time of speaking in the past. So number one, past continuous tense is used to indicate or to show the action which was continued at the time of speaking in the past. So that will be written in past. Here at the time of speaking past, or you can say present also, because when someone recalls the action which was continued in past time, so if that will be remembered, that will be recalled, so that will be translated in past continuous tense, or by using the rules, the formula of past continuous tense, we write that sentence. For example, he was playing cricket. So this work was continue. They were watching TV and Rahim was repairing the car. So watching, playing and repairing, these three works were continue in past. So that is why here past continuous has been used. See the next rules. An act which is being done how? Habitually and frequently. When any action which is being done how? Habitually and frequently. In such a sentence, we often get always, continually, constantly. Then there we use past continuous tense. So where past continuous tense is used? When any action is being done how? By someone habitually or frequently. Often we get always, continually and constantly. Then that will be written, that will be spoken in past continuous tense. Let's see the examples. Number one, they were always abusing others. So here these peoples have the habit of, maybe they have habit, they are frequently, they used to do this work. Number next is, she was constantly crying. So this girl has the habit of doing, or this girl constantly doing this frequently used to do this work. That is why here past continuous tense has been also used. Next is, he was continually threatening us. So here maybe this has the habit or the this, you know, frequently time to time he used to threaten someone. So that is why here these all the three sentences have been written or translated in past continuous tense. Let's see the next rules. That is rule number third. The third situation here, when a work which is continue. So condition is, when a work is continue in past time, or and suddenly another work is happened during it, written in past indefinite tense. See, this rule can be applied from both side. When a work which was in past, and the work in the same way, a work which was continue, so that will be written in past continuous tense. Or a work which was continue in past time, and suddenly another work is happened during the work which was continue in past time. So the work which was happened suddenly, that will be written, that will be spoken in past indefinite tense. Is it clear? A work which was continue when in past time, and if any work suddenly, if another work, any other work suddenly happened during the this work, so the work which happened suddenly, that will be translated in this tense, not the work which was continue. The work which was continue, that will be written in past continuous, but the work which will happened suddenly during past continuous, the sudden work will be translated in past indefinite. Let's see the example. See, number one, when I was sleeping. So sleeping, this work was continue in past time, and someone knocked the door. So this knocking work happened suddenly during this work. So here knocking, this work has been translated or written in past indefinite by using second form. See the next example. When he arrived, his wife was washing her clothes. So washing the clothes, you know, washing clothes, this action was continue, and this action happened during this. So that will be written in past indefinite, and the action which was continue, that will be written in past continuous tense. So next example, let's see the next example here. The boy was knocked down. This was a work which was suddenly happened by a car while crossing the road. So crossing work was continue. So he was just crossing the road. At the moment, suddenly a car came and hit him, and he was knocked down. So the work which was happened suddenly, that was translated written in past indefinite, and the work which was written in past continuous tense. See the next example here. The sun was just setting. You know, this work was in process, and at that moment another work was happened, that as they reached this station. So as they reached this station, that will be written in past indefinite, and the work which was continue, that will be in the in past continuous tense. I hope this is clear. Let's see the next point here. Situation number four, when two work happen during past time. No, when two work happen during past continue, written past continuous tense. When two work happen, you can say happening, you can say during, you know, continue at a past in past time. When two work continue at a past, you know, in past time, that will be written in past tense. So here the spelling of a tense is not clear, not correct. So let's see the example here. Number one, while he was reading. So reading verb was continue. Sita was playing. So playing verb was continue. So reading and playing, these two verb were continue when this, you know, that is why in both the sentence past continuous has been used. See the next sentence. While Ram was singing, Rahul was reading. See the next example here. While they were playing and I was watching TV. So playing and watching, these two verbs were continue in past at the same time. So these two sentences will be written, these two verbs will be written in past continuous tense. I hope this tense, I mean past continuous tense, has been cleared to you all.